Hey everyone! I previously made a video about my first impressions of the Bambu Lab A1 Combo, but today I'm going to show you what happened when I first powered on the printer. We'll also take a look at two impressive features of the Bambu Lab A1 3D printer: motor noise cancellation and vibration compensation. The first screen that popped up said, "Unleash your creativity," and that's exactly what I plan to do with this printer, but clearly not today. I hit start, selected my region, and then spent about 10 minutes trying to connect the printer to Wi-Fi. That didn't work, so I skipped that for now and moved on to the next step. I consented to the license agreement, and I found myself agreeing to participate in Bambu Lab's user experience program. After that came the calibration screen, which presented three options: motor noise cancellation, vibration compensation, and auto bed leveling. Since all options were selected by default, I hit start and the calibration process began. I will demonstrate a few steps from the calibration sequence and say a few words about each feature. For motor noise cancellation, the printer moves back and forth along the x-axis, from the center to the positive direction and back to the center, then from the center to the negative x direction and back to the center. This movement is repeated along the y-axis. This is carried out across a speed range of 50 millimeters per second to 300 millimeters per second in 50 millimeters per second increments for each direction. According to Bambu Lab, this feature runs a calibration that measures subtle differences in each motor. By analyzing these variations, the printer adjusts the motors for smoother operation, significantly reducing noise during printing. This feature has been widely praised on the Bambu Lab forums for effectively minimizing motor noise. I can't say what the noise levels would be like during a full print without this calibration, but just listening to the motor noise during calibration shows how the noise drops off after each stage. Now here's a quick look at the printer performing the calibration steps. Motor noise cancellation is also extended to motions that involve moving both the X and Y axes simultaneously, which is what happens whenever the printer prints a circle or makes circular motions on the horizontal plane. Next up is vibration compensation. This feature measures the mechanical resonance modal of the printer for vibration compensation, particularly vibrations caused by acceleration during printing. It helps the printer adjust in real time, reducing artifacts that can affect print quality while also enabling faster print speeds. During this process, the printer performs a frequency sweep from 0 to 500 Hz. I personally recommend running vibration compensation whenever there's a change in the printer's environment. For example, adding books to a shelf that's part of your desk can alter its vibration characteristics. My desk has shelves, and I usually add weight to help stabilize it for my other fast printer. I ran this vibration calibration before adding that extra weight, so once I do, I'll need to recalibrate. Both the motor noise cancellation and vibration compensation calibrations completed successfully. The last option is auto bed leveling, which is pretty much standard, or at least should be, for all 3D printers. One thing that stood out to me was how much faster the A1 took its measurements compared to the AnchorMake M5. It also uses significantly more measurement points. The initial bed leveling uses 49 points, 7x7, similar to the AnchorMake M5. However, after that, the A1 performs a second round of measurements using a 21x21 grid for a total of 441 measurement points. So, that's what happened when I first switched on the Bambu Lab A1 Combo. Right from the start, it's packed with advanced features like active motor noise cancellation and vibration compensation, both designed to enhance the print quality and overall user experience. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more tests and reviews of the Bambu Lab A1 Combo. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell for future updates.